hope you guys are doing well. If this is the first time that you're watching me, then my name is Shriya and welcome to my channel Beauty and the Code. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel by clicking on the subscribe button and the bell notification next to it so that you'll be notified of all my future uploads. Having said that, let's get started with today's video. So today's video, I'll be talking about depigmentation creams. I have around 6 products with me and I'm going to do some comparison of those creams and I'll conclude in the end of the video which is the best depigmentation cream and for which skin type and which one worked least for me. Now, the depigmentation creams that I'm talking about in this video are primarily the ones that are either recently launched or they are launched in say a gap of 6 months or so. One or two options are the ones which are older ones, but remaining 4 options are the ones that are just newly launched or say in a 6 months gap they have been released. So I've been trying and testing all of these creams and I definitely have a clear winner out of them. So without any further ado, let's get started. So I'm going to start off with the one that worked least for me and this one is by the Faceshop. You must have heard a lot about this cream. All the YouTubers have been raving about this one and this one is the White Seed Brightening Serum. And this one is by the brand The Face Shop, which is like a Korean brand, skincare brand, and they are humongously famous for so many products which have been like people have been going crazy about their skincare range and they have been loving them. Now I also got influenced from other YouTubers and bloggers and I ended up getting this one, which is for which was for 1800 and I got only 50 ml of the product. Now, I gave this brightening serum almost 1.5 months of testing and trial and somehow I did not really feel, you know, that my skin had actually become brighter or the spots had reduced. Maybe I was impatient or I don't know why, but it did not really work like the best on me. I have used many other depigmentation creams and serums which have worked better for me. So somewhere I just felt that I invested 1800 in this and I did not really get that effective kind of a result that I was hoping for. Maybe it has worked for you, but for me it has worked average. So this one has white seed brightening, so it's a white seed brightening serum, so the main ingredient mentioned here is white seed. Nothing else about the ingredients are mentioned on the packaging itself. And I don't have the box for it now, but anyways, this one is the 6th option that I would recommend. Like, this one is good for oily, normal to oily skin. If you're someone who has dry skin, then definitely the hydration that you'll get from this is just not enough. Only if you have like normal to oily skin, then this one you may consider as an option. So out of the 6 options that I have, I'm going to rate this to 6th one. So the next depigmentation option is by Patanjali and this one is their Saundarya Alovera Gel, which has Kesar and Chandan. I'm just going to read out what the product claims. A unique blend of Chandan and Kesar with Alovera Gel provides antioxidant and nourishment properties, which makes this complexion free from roughness and dullness. Also helps to control sunburn, tanning, dark spots and pigmentation. Now I have to tell you guys that I'm someone who was suffering from back acne, like severe back acne, and every time, like during that time of the month, those acnes used to get aggravated and then they would calm down and again next month they used to get aggravated. It was a non-stop cycle and I just tried this for 1 week only to calm down my acne. There was no other intention of other than that. And I noticed a significant difference in my skin and my acne had reduced and also it started, you know, my skin started looking glowy. And to my surprise, this is like just 100 rupees and this is like 150 ml of gel that you get. I will literally call it a wonder gel. I'm not someone who like loves Patanjali products, but this one is such a huge exception for me this has worked really, 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 really well. And if you're someone who suffers from back acne a lot, then definitely give this a try. I also tried this on my face, but I don't know why on my face it just did not make that much huge difference the way it made on my back skin. So I will recommend you that if you are someone who has pigmentation issues on some other body parts, like not just face but other body parts, then definitely this is a very safe option to use and a very inexpensive one too. I also recommended this to one of my friends and she also mentioned the same thing, that her back acne has reduced to half and literally her skin is healing now. So I'm really thankful that I tried this Patanjali Saundarya Aloe Vera Gel, and I'll definitely recommend this as one of the best depigmentation gels that are available. So the third one that I have already spoken about in my previous depigmentation creams comparison video is again by Fabindia, and this one is their depigmentation cream, which is like intensive depigmentation cream. Now I'm someone who has tried this for the longest time. Like I had given this 6 months and this has definitely proven me correct. Like it has worked so well on my pigmented areas and it has worked so well on my acne prone skin. This one can also be used by people with other skin types, so I will definitely recommend this because this is cream based, this is not gel based, and it's a very thick sort of a cream. It looks like cold cream, but on application it doesn't really make my skin oily, and I know I'm left with very less cream, and you can tell that this one is completely tried and tested. So this one is a very good depigmentation option. However, Fabindia has changed their packaging and all, and this is their new packaging. So the price of this has increased from 390 to 490, 100 rupees just for the packaging. I hate Fabindia for that. But anyways, the product is great, and this one also has vitamin E in it. So that is like really good for skin. So this is another very good option available as a depigmentation cream. So the next option that I want to talk about is by Juicy Chemistry, and this one is their cold press rosehip oil. Now my friend Garvita, she suggested me to get my hands on this one because she said that people in US are just going crazy for rosehip oil and you should definitely give it a try, and she wanted to know genuinely my opinion if rosehip oil really works as a depigmentation oil or not. And I have to tell you, and I have to tell her, that this really works as a good depigmentation oil. Now, there are some pros and cons of using rosehip oil. There's nothing wrong in using rosehip oil on oily skin as well, because I have used it and I have tried and tested it and it did not break me out. So that's a good thing about it. The only concern that I had was like it gives yellow stain on the skin. So it's not something that you can use it in the daytime. You have to use it during nighttime. And apart from that, it gives a very foul smell. Like I was expecting rosehip oil to have that rosy kind of a fragrance. My bad for assuming that, but I don't know, it gives a very herbal fragrance. And herbal also, it's not a very good herbal sort of a fragrance. I actually don't like the fragrance. That's why I'm not able to describe it. So I don't like the fragrance of it, but as a depigmentation oil, it really works well. Like it really works well. But yeah, the only thing is it does give a yellow cast on the face when you use it. And apart from that, I don't have any complaints with it. And it does work as a very good depigmentation oil. So I just wanted to read out what they've written about the rosehip oil so that you're more aware of what it is. So rosehip oil is a sweet smelling oil derived from the seeds of rose bushes. It has a high concentration of essential fatty acids which are beneficial to the skin. It has high content of vitamin C and is an effective antioxidant which helps reduce the appearance of scarring, hyperpigmentation and skin damage. So it definitely claims for being a depigmentation agent, and it definitely does the job well. However, it is also saying that it's a sweet smelling oil, but trust me, it's not a sweet smelling oil. It's very herbal and it looks yellowish and it gives a yellow tint. But apart from that, as a depigmentation oil, it works the best. So 30 ml of the oil costs for around 580, which is like an expensive choice. So if you see cost effectiveness, I can just say that Patanjali's one and the Fabindia one is a really good option. The next depigmentation gel is the one from Plum, and this one is like recently launched in the market, and this one is known as their green tea renewed clarity night gel, and this one is specifically for oily and acne prone skin. So if you are who falls under the category of oily and acne prone skin like I have, then this one is an extremely good option for you. In fact, this is the best option that you have if you have oily skin, because this is gel based, it doesn't break me out at all, and in fact it has some ingredients which actually help in removing the acne and removing the zits from your skin. It has worked really wonders on my skin, and I trust this brand extremely well with their products. Especially the green tea range has worked wonders on my skin. This one is no exception, and the fragrance is also awesome. 50 ml of this gel cost $5.75, which is a tad bit expensive, I would say. But again, if you have oily skin and if you have acne prone skin, then definitely invest in this one because it really works wonders. So the main ingredients in this are acne fighting green tea. It has brightening licorice and it has skin clarifying willow bark. And it also says that willow bark is something which has anti-inflammatory properties as well. So I was mentioning that this one has really worked wonders on my acne, and it has helped me in reducing the acne and the zits. And definitely, if you ask me, being a person with oily skin, I will highly recommend you to use this one. So I have saved the best depigmentation option for you in the last. I know I'm sorry for holding you for that long, but this one is by Organic Harvest. I don't think this will come as a surprise to you because I have been going gaga about this in almost every second video of mine. So this one is the Organic Harvest Skin Lightening Cream, and this one has white mulberry and organic daisy flower extracts, and these are the major two ingredients that help in skin lightening. Now, I'm not saying that this is something like Fair and Lovely or so, that you know it helps in getting fairer skin. No, it does say that it is skin lightening, but it actually works excellent on the pigmentation and on reducing the dark spots. Now, one thing about this cream is you just have to be a little patient for it to work. It takes around 1 month, proper 1 month, to show the results. But trust me, you guys, once this starts working on your skin, you will never turn back to any other depigmentation cream. And this one is something that will suit all skin types. Even people with oily skin can definitely use this, because I religiously use this and I'm someone who has oily skin. This one is a cream gel based kind of a formula, and this one just melts into the skin and it doesn't make my skin oily or so. And in the morning I wake up with a very nice and fresh and supple skin. The only concern with this cream is that the fragrance is very strong. I do find the fragrance very overpowering. So if you're someone with sensitive nose, just you would absolutely hate this one. So if you're okay with the fragrance to be a little strong, then you can definitely give this a try, and trust me, this is going to work for you. Now, 50 grams of the product comes for $7.95. I know this is like very costly for a skin lightening cream, but trust me, you guys, if you invest in a good depigmentation cream, I'm sure you will get a clearer skin and a better skin, and that is what our intention is at the end of the day. So definitely give this a try. Now, coming to the rating for each of the creams that you have been waiting for, definitely Organic Harvest is a winner for me. So this one is the first one that I'll recommend. Second one has to be from Plum. This one is like a gel formula, and if you are someone with oily skin and skin that breaks out very easily, then definitely go for this one. My third recommendation would be from Juicy Chemistry, which is their Rosehip oil. Definitely this can be used throughout all skin types, from dry, very dry, normal to oily skin. This one is like a universal oil which can be used. So this one is the third one according to my recommendation. Fourth one has to be Fabindia's depigmentation cream. Fifth one is Patanjali's Alovera Gel. Last one, which has worked least on my skin as a depigmentation agent, is by Faceshop, and this one is their White Seed Brightening Serum. So that was everything about depigmentation creams and their comparison. I hope this video was helpful for you guys, and if it was, please let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this video, don't forget to give this video a big fat thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Follow me on all my social medias, links to which I'll be leaving in the description box below. And I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye!